Dear students, in part 1 we have seen how to draw the network diagram. Now we are going to see critical path method. Here we will see what is project management, what are all the phases of project management, guidelines for network construction, and a case study for critical path method, and find out project completion time and total float and free float for non-critical activities. We will see what is project management. A project consists of interrelated activities which are to be executed in a certain order before the entire task is completed. A project has very many activities. They are interrelated. They have to be executed in a particular order. Then only the project will be completed. The activities are interrelated in a logical sequence known as precedence relationship. This precedence relationship is very important and has to be strictly adhered to when we are making the network diagram. Project is represented in the form of a network for the purpose of analytical treatment to get solutions for scheduling and controlling the activities. These things we will see later. Now, techniques. There are two techniques. One is critical path method. Here the activity durations are deterministic in nature. And the second one is PERT, performance evaluation and review technique. Activity durations are probabilistic in nature here. PERT we will see in the next video. CPM we are going to see now. Phases of project management. Phase one is planning. Here we are dividing the project into distinct activities. Then we are estimating the time requirement for each activity. Then we are establishing the precedence relationship among the activities. Finally, we are constructing the arrow diagram, also called as network diagram. Second phase is scheduling. Here we are determining the start and end time of each and every activity. Finally, we are doing the controlling. Here we use the arrow diagram and time chart for continuous monitoring and progress chart. So we also do a crashing of the project, which we will see in the final part, part 4. Now, guidelines for network diagram constructions. I have shown you an activity with two events, starting event and ending event. The starting event and ending event of an activity are called tail event and head event respectively. So this event before the start of the activity is called tail event. This event immediately after the end of this activity is called head event. The network should have a unique starting node. So for the entire network, there must be a unique starting node called tail event. And similarly, the network should have a unique completion node, that is head event. So for the entire project, for the entire project network, there must be a unique completion node, ending node, that is called head event. That is what is shown here. No activity should be represented by more than one arrow in the network. See, here there is an activity A which is represented by two arrows. This is not allowed. No two activities should have the same starting node and ending node. Now here, there are two activities which are represented by a single arrow. This also is not allowed. Please note that two arrows cannot represent the same activity, or two activities cannot be represented by the same arrow. Both are not allowed. Dummy activity is an imaginary activity indicating the precedence relationship only. Please note that here, A and B are combined predecessors to C. That is, A should be completed, B also should be completed before I start the activity C. And A and B cannot be represented by a single arrow. Therefore, I have represented two arrows and to represent A separately, B separately, and used a dummy activity so that this precedence relationship is justified. Mistakes you must not make. Looping. Please note here, it is starting from this. It is a starting node. And then ending also in the same point. Starting node and ending node cannot be same. That means it is a looping. This is not permitted. Now, dangling. We will see here, this event is dangled. This activity is dangled, right? Because this this event and this event together form two separate head events. Two head events are not allowed in a network. There should be a unique head event in a project network. Therefore, what I do is I join this, then it completes a perfect network. This is not an activity at all, but it completes the network. Now, redundancy. Please note here, B and C are combined predecessors to activity D. Therefore, I have used two dummy activities to say that D should be started after B, D should be started after C. But this is redundant because I can represent the same with a single dummy event. See, only one dummy event I have used, and D is after B, B is also after C. Therefore, B and C are combined predecessors to activity D, which is well followed in this network diagram. Therefore, this particular network is not allowed where I have used redundant dummy activity. Right? Finally, flouting the precedence rules. So all these predecessor rules should be followed in the network diagram. We will see case study. This is a table wherein activities are given, predecessors are given, that is a precedence relationship between the activities are shown here, and the duration of the activities also shown here. Since it is a critical path method, then the durations are deterministic in nature. There is only one time for each activity. So A has got only 2 weeks or 2 months, whatever be it. I have not mentioned the unit here. What is needed is construct the CPM network. We have to construct for this table the CPM network. Determine the critical path and project completion time. Right, that is what we will have to see here after this. Then finally, compute the total floats and free floats for non-critical activities. So we'll have to find out the critical activities, so which have no, what do you call it, slack, right? It has to be completed in the time. There is no time available for delay. Okay. Now, important points here are activities C and D will have a common head event. Why activity C? Because C and D are combined predecessors to activity H and to activity I. Therefore, C and D will have a common head event. Okay. Then activities F, G, H will have a common head event. You know why? Because F, G, H also combined predecessors to event K and L. Therefore, F, G, H will have a common head event. Right. Activities J and K will have a common head event, because J and K are combined predecessors to activity N, right? J and K are common predecessors to activity N. Activities L, M, and N will have a unique head event, because L, M, and are the final events. They are not predecessors to any event, any activity. Therefore, L, M, N will have a unique head event for the in the project network. Now we will see the network diagram. Draw the network diagram. Activity and predecessors are given here. We are going to follow only for these two columns because I have to draw the diagram, right? Therefore, I have left this gap. Now, first, activity A and B and C, all are not having any predecessors. Therefore, all the three are starting activities. So, B is also a starting activity. C is also a starting activity. Okay. Now, B is a predecessor to D. So, D has got a predecessor B. D has got a predecessor B. And that is what is followed here. And why I have joined C and D with a common event? Because C and D are predecessors, combined predecessors to activity H. Therefore, I have joined it with a common event. Now, E has got a predecessor A. A is predecessor to E. Therefore, I have drawn this. Now, F also has a predecessor A. Therefore, I am drawing it separately as an event here. Now, G has got a predecessor B here. Please note here. So, G is also drawn here. Now, we will see. H has got a combined predecessor C and D. Therefore, I got this common event, and therefore, I am joining this. Please note that this F, G, and H are FGHR combined predecessors to K and L. Therefore, I've combined this with a common event, head event. Now, I is there. I has got combined predecessors of C and D. Therefore, C and D are there here. They're combined with a common head event. So, I'm drawing this I event after this. Okay. Now, J has got predecessor E. Therefore, I've drawn this here. Okay. Now, K has got a combined predecessor FGH. Therefore, after FGH, from this common event, I have drawn here. But why I am joining this J and K to a common head event? Because J and K are combined predecessors to activity N, right? Now, L has got a predecessor FG and H. Therefore, after FGH, common event is there. So, I have drawn this L event, L activity here. Now, M is having a predecessor, I. Therefore, after I have drawn this M. Please note here, N I have to draw it here. I have drawn this N here. Why I have combined this L, M, N? Because they are the final events which are not predecessor to any. Therefore, I have drawn this with a unique head event. So this completes the network diagram. Now what we will see? We have to write the activity duration here. This duration A is 2, so I have drawn this. Then I will draw for B as 5. So for 5. For C, 4 units. For C, 4 units. Then for D, 5 units here. For E, 7 units. For F, 3 units. And for G, 3 units. And then for H, 6 units. So I've drawn this here. For I, 2 units. For this, 2 units. For J, 5 units. Here is J, 5 units. Then for K, it is 4 units. Then for L, 3 units. And then for M, it is 12 units here. And then N, 8 units. So we have drawn the activity duration also and completed the network diagram. Now we are going to see earliest starting time for each and every event. For now, I will tell you the formula is ESJ is equal to maximum of ESI plus DIJ. I will show you with a visualization. Please, I have shown here activities there from the activity diagram. Now I just want to start with 00, right? Now for this activity A, this ESI is 0 plus duration is 2. Therefore 0 plus 2 is 2, right? So node 2, it is 2. For node 3, you will see here node 3, 00 plus 5. ESI plus duration. ESI is the previous node, the starting time, earliest starting time, 0 plus 5, 5 here. I have drawn it here. But when it comes here also it is easy here. 5 plus 5 is 10. ESI is 5 here. Duration is 5. Therefore, 10 here. But when it comes to here, we have to see that which are all the possible ES. One is 0 plus 4 is 4. And here, this is earliest starting time is 5. 5 plus 5 is 10. So I have to take the maximum of this. So 4 or 10, I have to take the maximum 10. Therefore, this is what I have done. See, this is what I have completed and shown here. Likewise, we can do it for all the nodes. And then we will see here. Now, I have started with 0 here. And then I filled up 2 here. And then it is 5 here, 0 plus 5. And then here I filled up 10 because 5 plus 5 is 10 here maximum. And then here 9 I filled in because 2 plus 7 is 9. And then we'll go to 6. Here 16. Please see here, I have to show here. This 2 plus 3 is 5. 5 plus 3 is 8. Here 10 plus 6 is 16. So the maximum is 10 plus 6. So I put 16 here. And then here 12, because 10 plus 2 is 12. And then here 20. 9 plus 5 is 14. 16 plus 4 is 20. Therefore, maximum is 16 plus 4, 20 I put. And then finally, you've got 12 plus 12 is 24. 20 plus 8 is 28. So 28 is maximum I filled in. So all the earliest starting times are filled up here. Now you have to fill up latest completion time for each event. Now I have shown an example here. Please show here, see here, 28 and 28. Now this is the end event, so I have taken it as 28. For the end event, the earliest starting time and latest completion time will have to be same. Then 28 minus 8 is 20. And here 20 I have put here. 20 minus 4 is 16, it's put here. And please note here, 28 minus 3 is 25. Clear? 28 minus 3 is 25. And 20 minus 4 is 16. So I have taken the minimum most. So out of 25 and 16, 16 is the minimum. Therefore, I have taken this. Right. Yeah. Here, 28 minus 12 is 16 here. No choice. Okay. So we'll see that is what we have done. Let's see 16. How we have got? Because 20 minus 4 is 16, 28 minus 3 is 25. The lowest minimum was what you have to take. So we have taken this. Now we will find here from 28. So latest completion time we will find out. We'll start with 28. So 28 minus 8 is 20. And then here 28 minus 12 is 16. Then see 20 minus 4 is 16. Just now I explained you out of 25 and 16, 16 is the minimum. and then we will see here 15. 20 minus 5 is 15 here. We are subtracting from the latest completion time of the succeeding unit. Now here, please see here, it is 10 here. 16 minus 2 is 14, right? 16 minus 6 is 10 here. So 16 minus 6 is 10 here. 16 minus 2 is 14 here. So 10 is the minimum. I have taken 10. Okay. Then we will see here 5. 16 minus 3 is 13. Okay. 10 minus 5 is 5 here. Therefore, 5 is taken here, lowest. Then here 15 minus 7 is 8. 16 minus 3 is 13. Lowest is 8. And then here 8 minus 2 is 6. 5 minus 5 is 0. 10 minus 4 is 6. Therefore, least is 5 minus 5, 0 I have taken. So this completes the latest completion time for all the activities. Now find the critical path. Conditions for critical path are, these are all the conditions. ESI and LCI should be same. For any event, these two numbers should be same. This is the earliest starting time. This is the latest completion time. And similarly, for the succeeding event also, ECJ should be LCJ. This also should be equal to this. And then the difference between these two and the difference between these two should be duration of the time. Right? We will see here. We'll check it up. Critical path here. 1, 3, 4, 6, 8, 9. We will see that by checking here. 1, 3 is this activity. 1, 3 is B. And 3, 4 is D. And then 4, 6 is here. H. 6, 8 is K and 8, 9 is N. 8, 9 is here. Okay, 8, 9. Yeah. Now we will see here. This one. So 28 minus 8. 20, 20 is there. Right? Okay. Here 28, 28. The difference is 8. Now 20, 20 is there. 16, 16 is there. The difference is 4. And then here 16, 16 is there. 10, 10 is there. The difference is 6. Okay. And then here 5, 5 is there, 10, 10 are there, equal, and then 10 minus 5 is 5, and then 5, 5 are there, 5 is the duration, 5 minus 5 is 0, 0, 0 is there. Therefore, critical path is B, D, H, K, and N. That is what we have shown here. We can also find critical path by other means. We will see that now. What is total float? Total float is the amount of time that the completion time of an activity can be delayed without affecting the project completion time. So total float means we can delay that particular activity by this much time given by the total float, but the completion time of the project will not be affected. See, total float for an activity IJ is given by latest completion time of the succeeding event minus earliest starting time of the preceding event minus duration. But it is very easy to do it from here. Please note here, this ES minus ES here. This is ESJ, this is ESI, right? Okay. And here LC and ES. So LCJ minus ESI. So the difference between this LC and this ES minus duration is that total float. Clear? All I need to do is add this duration with this earliest starting time, subtract from this latest completion time. That is the total float. Now, free float is the amount of time that the activity completion time can be delayed without affecting the earliest starting time of the immediate successor activities in the network. That is, this will not be affected. Free float means we can delay this activity by this much time so that this will not be affected. This earliest starting time will always be main time. That we will see here now. Free float is ESJ minus ESI minus DIJ. Previously, what you have done, we have added this and the duration subtracted from the latest completion time. Now we are going to subtract from the earliest starting time. That's all. The difference is only either you subtract this total from the latest completion time or earliest starting time. So this is very easy to do it, and I will show you with an example here. For total float, 16 minus 10 minus 2. 60 minus 10. What is 10 plus 2? 12. So 16 minus 12 is 4. You see here? So 4 is the answer for total float. And then 12 minus 12. because I have to subtract this total from the earliest starting time, which is 12, 0. Therefore, this has got a free float of 0 and total float of 4. Now we are going to complete a critical activity. We'll have 0 total float and 0 free float. From this also, we can find out the CPM. Now we will see here how to find out the total floats and free floats for the completed project network diagram. We have completed this. We have also shown this critical path. We will see whether total float and free float are same. So please see here, total float and free float are 0 here. Why? This 28, this I have to add, no? 20 plus 8. So 28 I have to subtract from the latest completion. So total float is 0. From the earliest starting time, again, it is 0. 28 minus 28. Therefore, total float and free float are 0 here. Now for this, we will see. See, total float is 9. Free float is also 9. See, 28. What is that addition? 16 plus 3, 19. So 28 minus 19 is 9. Again, 28 is the early starting time. 28 minus 19 is 9 here. Then we will see for this activity. So this being a 28, same 28, this please note here, this activity duration time is there here, 12. And then 12 here, 12 plus 12 is 24. So 28 minus 24 is 4. Here also 28, 28 minus 24 is 4 here, right? Then we will see for this. The 16 plus 4 is 20. So 20 minus 20 is 0 and 20 minus 20 is 0. Right? And then we will see next for this. 9 plus 5 is 14. 20 minus 14 is 6. And here also 20 minus 14 is 6. And for this even we will see here. 10 plus 2 is 12. 16 minus 12 is 4 and 12 minus 12 is 0. Free float is 0. This is what we have seen in the example. Now for this here, 10 plus 6, 16 is the total. 16 minus 16 is 0. And here also 16 minus 16 is 0. For this we will see. 5 plus 3 is 8. 16 minus 8 is 8. Here also 16. 16 minus 8 is 8. Total float also 8. Free float also is 8. For this we will see here, the addition is 2 plus 3, 5. So 16 minus 5 is 11. Here also 16. 16 minus 5 is 11. For this, 2 plus 7 is 9. 15 minus 9 is 6. Here, the earliest starting time is 9. So 9 minus 9 is 0. Now for this case, here, please, here, 5 plus 5 is 10. 10 minus 10 is 0. Here also 10. 10 minus 10 is 0. Now for this activity, 4 plus 0, 4. 10 minus 4 is 6. Here also 10. 10 minus 4 is 6. Total float and free float. Now this is what I put it in the tabular form. The next slide here. For this here, 0 plus 2 is 2, 8 minus 2 is 6, and 2 minus 2 is 0. Now I have put it in the tabular form. Activities are shown here. It is also shown as the node numbers 1, 2, 1, 3, like that. Duration is given here. Total float and free float are, I have copied from there. And you can see that total float and free float are 0 here. So B is a critical path. And here also 0 and 0 are there. This is also again a critical path. And here also total float and free float are 0. And for item, for activity K also is there. Therefore, B, D, H, K, and N, the total float and free float are 0 or following critical path. B, D, H, K are the following the critical path. I will add the durations, will give you the 28 days. If the days are duration, 28 days. If the duration is weeks, 28 weeks. I think I have completed this session. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, recommend to your friends, and I'll stop sharing here.